Now, I will be skipping past all these cutscenes. We should go watch them on some other channel. Just for further reference. I believe I'm in a party right now. Let's get out of that. I might not be, but... Okay, no, I'm not. I make it as high as I can. first played this. Okay, when I first played this game, that first scene gave me Last of Us vibes. Really did. I'm gonna skip past all these clips. Watch them some others. Oh. I mean, the graphics in this game are great. I don't know if you noticed that. Damn, those are some good graphics. I may be the only one who noticed those graphics, but yeah, I already know about Blood and Sand on the Gauge. Please don't let this be copyrighted. Please let this not be copyrighted. Please don't copyright me. I hate it when that happens. Oh, dead deer. Go figure. Looks like a buck too. Good music choice though, I'll tell you that much. There's some bad music. Funny thing is, I'm going through all this water yet. I just went out hiking in the creek behind me, behind my house. And it just rained, so the water level was ridiculously high. My muck boots almost couldn't get through it. And of course, I didn't want to get wet. It's still cold as water, still gonna be cold as F. Okay, can't check my map or anything. Okay. Again, I've never had to check any of this, so never been curious about it, you know. Keeping your balance while in the river. Blah 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 blah. Don't be so the guys who make Ghost Recon, the guys who make this game should get together. Oh man, I played both games. I know how they're both good in their own rights. Don't be so serious. If you were to combine the two, that would probably make the best game probably ever. Not joking either. Jesus. Oh, crap. I hate that. It's on my nerves so much. I'm trying not to play this game without recording, but I make no promises. I'll do my best. Delivering cargo. I mean, the graphics are good. I mean, look at that.
What took you so long? It's not like the legend to come in late.
Had to wait out the storm. Lost my bike.
Sounds like you've been through the ringer.
That's an understatement.
Luckily, our goods are in perfect condition. Well, you did keep us waiting, but everything else seems to be in perfect order, so... Great work. We'll be awaiting the next delivery.
And I couldn't help it. It's the nostalgia that gets me. It's what it is. It's the nostalgia. Yes. Try to make this run as hard as possible. Okay, got it. We're here. I'm gonna try to make this run as hard as possible, but I make no promises. Please remember to like and subscribe, ring that bell, and comment down below if you want to see something else.
So, how does it feel to be back in the world of the living? Don't worry. I'm a doctor. Well, a coroner, originally. Call me Dead Man. I'm well acquainted with the dead. Not like you, of course. Contrary to the name, I've never actually died.
Delivery order for Sam Porter Bridges. Request transport of morphine to isolation ward for immediate administration to the president. Check the map on your cufflinks if you're lost. Sam, your friendly neighborhood dead man here. If you want to confirm you're headed the right way, check your compass. It'll never steer you wrong. Provided you have a destination, that is. Central wasn't just home to Bridges HQ. It was also the seat of the Reconstructionist movement. If the president hadn't required special treatment, she would have never left. And if she hadn't, we wouldn't have either.
I turned my mic off, sorry. Yeah, I slept through my alarm. oops. Oh man. I got bored, so. What is it now? I mean, I did get something from my uncle, though. Get it. Here it is. I don't know if I'll be able to get it all the way in the frame, but. Oh. Yeah, I can't even get it all the way in the frame. It's humongous. Saw that.
Like I said, the vital signs are all trending the same way.
No chance of a recovery then?
None that I can see. No.
We should start.
Shut up, asshole. I thought that was possible anyway. I figured that might happen. Why, thank you. I'm just going to skip past all this. Come on, hurry up, hurry up. Jesus, so slow. Like, holy shit. Care less. Oh, fantastic. Even better.
Sam, this is Die Hard. Dead men explained how to use the cuffs, right? Use them to check the location of the incinerator.
So I'm gonna check something. Okay, system. Options. Game settings. Okay, good. we got it on hard then.
Sam, I don't think I need to remind you, but every minute counts when transporting corpses for disposal. 48 hours following cardiac arrest, they go necro and become a fresh PT to make our lives hell.
Sway from side to side. I noticed that this whole time. That's why it's better to transport corpses on a vehicle rather than how I am one of those floating carriers is better. See that later in this, but...
President Bridget Strand was the symbol of American Reconstructionism. Even with the country shattered and its people scattered to the four winds, she never stopped believing they could be reunited. People held on to their hope that America would rise again because they believed in her. We believe that this country can be rebuilt. America lives on, together with Bridget's undying spirit.
Have a pleasant journey.
I'm gonna slow down. It's like once we get up towards the incinerator, I'll slow down. Just if I remember correctly, there's a shit ton of BTs
in
the past.
Yeah, just like that.
Talks to himself. 20.
Hey!
I have that. Okay, yes, I do. Let's put some glasses on. Screw it, my boss. Yeah. I know people say this is basically a walking simulator. It's not just a walking simulator. I know it sounds funny coming from me, but... Or may sound funny, but...
But I'm exactly where I wanna be. But I'm alone.
Please don't demonetize me for this. Get past those cutscenes, but that was one of the guys who died during that whole fiasco. If you watch the actual cutscenes. currently just trying to speedrun style this shit. Come on. I mean, this has 40 hours worth of playing to do. So yeah, there's a lot of... Finally. I'm definitely gonna use that. Yes, please. Something that's very satisfying about this game is, you'll see. There we go, gotcha. See? Yeah, so satisfying. You deserve more than just one light gold use.
Just a bit further now.
You're lucky it's just a little bit further. Yeah, we're gonna get swarmed by ETs once we incinerate this body. Which is actually his mother. Believe it or not. It's kind of crazy, I know.
That's the place, huh?
I ain't saving crap. No, thank you. I'm just gonna watch a couple YouTube videos while you guys watch these cutscenes.
Thank you. this?
BB-28. It's the unit Igor was assigned. It was hooked up to you when we found you in the crater.
But why is it here?
Because it's flagged for disposal. Central Knot's gone, and our headquarters along with it. Because that thing didn't do its job. It's all in Igor's logs.
But it's still alive.
It can't be repaired. And it can't survive outside the pod. Pity it if you want, but the decision has been made. It has to go. The director approved the order.
Position. I have to move before they realize I'm in here.
Sam, if one of those things eats you, it'll trigger a void out. You'll come back, sure, but the surrounding area will still be a crater.
I got an idea. Effective. Keep low and move cautiously. Thank you.
Not a moment too soon.
Bridges ID. Verifying ID. Clear. Welcome to Capital, not City. Proceed to distribution center.
Sam, come back to the distribution center. Check the location on your compass.
It's almost time to go, Sam.
Sam, this is Di Hartman. There's a private room set aside for your use. Bridges perk. Take a moment to clean up, wash all that Kyrellium off, then come to the president's office.
Sam, can you hear me?
For fuck's sake. Is it anything private anymore?
Oh, no. Except for taking a shower and going to the toilet, that is. I take it you were getting yourself cleaned up. Good. Come to the president's office as soon as you're done. She's waiting for you.
You did well, Sam. Thank you. Bridget may no longer be with us, but her legacy has a chance to live on. Sam, listen to me. America. Reconstructionism. Her dream isn't dead.
I don't want to hear it.
This is the face of our new hope. Our new America.
Homily.
My mother may be gone, but I'm here. And you, Sam, you're here too.
Been 10 years since you saw each other, right? And in all that time, she hasn't aged a day.
He knows why. My body's still on the beach. I don't get to grow older. But you do, Sam. You look good.
So you're serious, then, about reconnecting everyone and everything?
Someone has to succeed Bridget, Sam. More importantly, someone has to carry on her legacy and see our country rebuilt. Samantha America Strand, our new president. A new beginning for our people, for our nation. Under Emily's leadership, we'll reestablish the UCA, the United Cities of America. This is how we'll rebuild our country. But we'll need your help to do it, Sam.
No. I'm through with this. I said my goodbyes to all of you when I said them to Bridget.
We never forgot about you, Sam. You ran away. You cut us off.
Emily put together an expedition. The best of Bridges won. And went west.
I led them past craters in BT territory. I kept them safe while they searched for survivors.
Never once missed a BT. Saw him coming a mile away.
We convinced community after community to join the UCA, and we left behind our own people to help them. It took us 3 years, but we managed to make it all the way to Edgenaut City.
All the way to the Pacific. Jesus.
Yeah, but then everything went to hell. The team was wiped out, and Emily was taken.
Taken?
I'm not being kept in a cell or anything like that. I'm allowed to use their facilities and to speak with you whenever I want. I just can't leave the city.
It's all to safeguard the continued independence of Edgenaut City. Well, that's what her keepers are saying, at least. They want the UCA to leave them be. Emily's their insurance policy in case we don't.
Who are these assholes again?
Homo Demons. Militant separatist group. They run Edgenaut City.
I've heard of them. Bunch of terrorists who go around towns killing people and leaving craters.
Right. Nothing's off limits for them. Not even engineering void outs.
You think the suicide that took out Central Knot was one of theirs?
Could be. They're extremists like the demons everywhere, plotting in the shadows. They're decentralized by nature. No one organization to rule them all. Just a common ideology.
I know not everyone shares our vision for the future. If we Americans don't come together again, humanity won't survive. I carried my mother's message to people all across the country. But not everyone was willing to accept it.
More than a few would rather stay isolated. Keep to themselves. Go it alone. Like you, Sam. They think that America can only be rebuilt by force, by men who tell them what to do, who take away their freedom and put them in shackles.
What'd you put on me, huh? You know better than the demons. Just another kind of cult.
They're not shackles, Sam. They're a symbol of our bonds. That's what we need right now. Not to stand apart, but to come together. To form chiral knots and reconnect.
Sam, we want you to go west and finish what Emily started. The people she left behind have been hard at work, setting up chiral network terminals. But these terminals are still isolated. We need you to bring them online. And for that, you'll need a qubit. This contains all the necessary security and operations protocols to integrate a terminal into the chiral web. Take the qubit west, Sam, and reconnect the people of our great nation. And when you get to Edge Knot City, find Emily and bring her home.
After that, I'll take over the presidency and carry on Mother's work to save the country.
This was Bridget's dying wish. This is how we'll move forward.
Please, Sam. We need you.
I'm Sam Porter Bridges now. I'm not a Strand. Hell, I'm not even part of this outfit. You all saw to that. I'm not getting involved with you or anyone else ever again.
Wait!
See? It's like I'm not even here. Same as it ever was.
Sam! Sam! Hold on. Stop!
Listen to me. America needs you. Both of you.
Yeah, covering the world in cable didn't bring an end to war and suffering. Don't act surprised when it all comes apart if you try to do it again. Round and round it goes. Connect, reconnect. It's not that simple.
All right, Sam. Just take it easy. I get it. You don't have to commit to anything now. Why not get some rest?
Good idea. We all need our sleep. Leave it too long and you're liable to reconnect with the other side. The necessary maintenance has been completed. Various adjustments and fine-tuning for your benefit. You can use it again. For once, it would seem that Dooms and BBs are a good combination. Or perhaps the two of you have something of an affinity for one another.
Wait!
Good morning, Sam.
Sam, this is Di Hardman. You were out like a log. Must have been beat. Private rooms come with all the basic amenities. Shower, toilet, etc. Drop in when you need to rest. Inspect your gear, review info, or whatever else. If you have any questions, feel free to ask our staff. But before you do, why not check things out for yourself? See how Bridges operates these days.
Hey there. Believe we've met. I oversee delivery operations as well as maintenance and repairs. Nice to have you on board. I'm Mama, in case I didn't mention it before. Those there are strands. Not just used for packing, by the way, but for identification, too. Take a closer look and you'll see. See the red there? That's your blood.
Sam, this is Deadman. I calibrated your BB based on physiological data we collected from you earlier. It's still just the best guess, though. After you take it out for a spin, we can check if you're in sync and tweak the BB sensitivity as needed.
This case will remove any chiral matter still clinging to your suit. Speaking of suits, blue is for delivery personnel, red for medical, orange for corpse disposal, and black for security.
Devoted to uncovering the secrets of the beaches and the Death Stranding, as well as those of Dooms and Repatriates. The shower in your room was designed with chiral decontamination in mind. Chiral matter can adversely affect hormone secretion and nervous function. There's a correlation between exposure and the development of phobias, as well as, in extreme cases, violent and suicidal impulses. Chiralian contamination has even been postulated as a trigger for the onset of Dooms. I should add that these showers have another function. The collection of blood, hair, fluids, and other natural waste products. They provide a non-invasive means to monitor your exposure to Corellium and your overall health. And I freely admit a chance to study the unique properties of your physiology, you being a repatriate and all.
Thank you.
See if these fit. I think they do. Looks like.
There's moving it up. Go ahead and put those balls in.
Seen anything like that.
And Phil?
Cal? Pretty much. Dominic? Pretty much. Did not see that one coming.
Alright, Dylan, so... and make responsible decisions. But you see, your dad is one that I like to say wears his heart on his sleeve. And this is good, good because, you know, he'll probably give you the shirt on his back and tell him he's dead because he could be, number one, he could be taken advantage of, and number two, if you make decisions whenever you're extremely happy or extremely upset or feeling any kind of emotion, it's not the time to make these decisions. So he was upset, went out to the bar. His friends, they had his own driver in the car, but the car is small, and they decided that since he's tall, they make him drive sparingly. See, this is again where he can take advantage. So kind of got him into some trouble. I mean, yes, it was his decision to drive or whatever, but your true friends, if they are real friends, would not have believed
you.
No matter, even if, per se, maybe you weren't actually drunk yet, because after a while you build up a tolerance, and one beer to you may not be what one beer to me is. You are, number one, you're going to be bigger. So your body's going to tolerate it better than somebody that's really small. So you might not actually feel drunk, but when you blow in that machine, it's going to say you are. Because it doesn't take much to set off that sensor. So, but I mean, he admits he was appreciative of the money. He admits that. But I'm just using that to
see
because I don't want you to think we start driving here very soon that, oh, well, you know, they only gave me 1 year. I mean, I don't think I'll
do it. It'll be something.
Well, it'll be enough to sell a machine. That is what you don't want. Because that is very, very difficult. And then you're going to have to answer me. And I'm going to do it many times. The cops, they're just going to do their thing and they're going to let you go, right? They're going to sit here and give you a bunch of shit to pay and make your life hell, but in the end, they're going to go away. You want to see them. Me, you got to deal with me for the rest of your life. So, I'm going to be working with the cops. So,
yeah, my friend always says, oh, you're not so nice. I'll be, wait, you're going to show me. That's so nice to meet
you. It's like you're something stupid.
That'll take about 15 minutes.
No. Yeah, but I'm not being difficult. I know you don't understand yet, but I'm not being difficult just to be a pain in your ass. I'm being difficult because I'm trying to make sure that you don't make any life altering. These next few years are going to be the years when you make life altering decisions. By life altering, you think of me.
Like, very, very dangerous and stupid decisions.
That can negatively affect your life. I mean, it's not the end of your life, of course. You know, I mean, you're gonna go on, you're gonna move on, but there are things that can drastically change the way your life functions and the way you carry on. You might not. We need to go outside.
Yeah, so
it
took the trash out of
here. I mean, I had Dominic when I was 2 years older than you. And I, of course, you know, it's okay and everything, but that was a decision that really affected my life because no longer could I sleep in, no longer could I, a lot of my friends disappeared because they didn't have kids and they didn't want to be around somebody that did, or a lot of them had kids, but because we came from a small town and everybody has kids, but they were still doing things that I wasn't going to do because I had kids and they didn't. So now I'm the prude or stuck up. But later down the road, you see that maybe there isn't a question here. So my shrewdness is ultimately it's the reason you guys are still with me. Because it's very common for teenage parents to raise their kids and grandkids and never raise them. What that means in a courtroom is if they can't charge you as a kid anymore, That means that one fuck-up, instead of being, you know, 6 months in a juvenile hall like a kid would get, you get 20 years. Because they charge you as an adult. So these people that are, like, bringing guns to school or killing people, stupid shit, they, I mean, they're only 14 years old and you ruined their whole life. So this here is rather simple to do. So we're going to do this a few times with a couple different ingredients. Vegetables and meal for packets, place them in the slow cooker, combine seasoned packet with one cup of water, and pour it in slow cooker. Stir and break apart meat. Break apart the meat, cook on low approximately for 8 to 10 hours or 4 to 6 on high. The longer the cook will result in a more tender meat, so that means we want to cook it longer and chewier. Because we don't want it to be chewy like Chris's.
Nice for the last 3 days.
I think your grandfather's wrong.
About what?
He said we had 6 more weeks of spring. I think so.
Yeah, but it's like you're not wearing one.
That's what the devil's advocate people are playing is that the government, the way that they get everybody to abide and follow rules is they take away censorship, which they're already doing by making us be, you know, extra sensitive to people's feelings, and making it to where you can't post certain stuff on social media or social media takes it down.
That makes no sense. Like.
And the argument is that, you know, this is America, it's just not right.
Yeah, honestly, it isn't. You can say whatever you want, it's the point. I mean, you mean, if it's something that's racial,
this is the game. You have freedom of speech. You are free to say whatever you want.
But you're not exempt from the consequences.
Exactly. You are free if you want to go into a bank and say, stick them up. I want your money. Well, that's fine. Go ahead and do it. But I can't guarantee you
that you're not going to be charged with the bank robbery charge.
Yeah.
With theft of money.
No kind of theft.
If you can lie to the cop, that doesn't mean you're not going to get an obstruction charge.
They're probably going to find out.
Now, if it was like 1800s, they probably wouldn't find out unless you told them. Somebody knew about it.
True.
Nowadays, it's much easier to figure that shit out.
Nowadays, we have all this technology, and we have video doorbells. So basically, anybody that's got a video doorbell can tell by watching it if they're nosy what time the name's going to work.
After a while, some law's gonna be passed where cops can check the footage from the Ring doorbells and shit. Eventually, some law's gonna be passed.
Oh, they can do that by getting a warrant.
Yeah.
They can already do that by getting a warrant. So what I'm telling you is that your friends, which I mean, I know this isn't the case yet, but I'm just warning you. What I'm trying to tell you is if you get a bunch of friends together and they say something like, hey man, let's go put some dog shit on these person's porch and light it on fire.
Which, that's the stupidest thing I've ever heard.
When we were kids, we did that. And that was perfectly fine because there was no way to tell that it was you.
Yeah, that's all the best.
But now, or they saw you, usually at 2 in the morning, nobody can see you.
Everyone's gonna be too asleep to care.
But now, you will be caught. So whatever plan your friends have to do whatever it is they want to do, you just be very careful.
Just pull out the forget about the security.
You just automatically know that somehow or another. Somebody's going to find out and you're going to end up with it. You might not realize how yet, because you haven't fully thought it through, but just know.
Nowadays, you can check fingerprints, DNA. I mean, they're selling shit from the toilet. The dirt they can help.
If someone takes a drink off of a soda,
they're going to know. If you're going to do something stupid, wear gloves. And maybe just keep an eye out for security cameras.
The ideal thing is not to do anything stupid.
Yeah, but eventually someone's going to do something stupid.
Somebody is going to catch you, just like Bryce got caught, even though he tried to burn the evidence. He still got caught for killing his family.
Why did he kill his family?
Apparently he was abused.
Apparently they were being mean to him when he was little, so he wanted revenge.
Revenge is he wants to get
even.
Yeah.
He wants to make them pay.
Not with money, but their lives.
Yes. Yeah.
Alright, so now
let's see those.
Now how this works is like this.
Yeah, it's coming up and off now.
Yep.
Ooh, I'm not excited about that.
I'm not nice.
They don't make money to live. Did you see Dentist or a judge? What's the... I'm done asking questions. Who are you sending that to? Uncle Jimmy? Back to the PlayStation.
Terminal there, you can browse the bridge's database, which has info on a range of subjects. You don't have clearance for everything, but there's still plenty you might find informative.
Well, have you had a chance to think it over? Chock full of Kyrellium, but safe for you Doom's guys to wear. That's all you'll need to go forth and reconnect the world. To make us whole again.
I'm a porter. I don't care about connecting anything. Or making knots. But I'll do what I have to help Amelie out.
Listen up, Sam. The terminals Amelie's people built in the towns and cities they passed through on their journey west are called knots. The infrastructure's there, but the Cairo network is offline. Right now, it's only capable of transmitting voice communications, sometimes wired, sometimes wireless, and a small amount of data. So, unless the necessary data stored on site, our chirograms won't show up. Emily and the other Bridges members you've seen around the place are grams generated with local data, in case you didn't know. Anyway, all you've got to do is find the knot, connect your Cupid, and bring chiral communications online. Once you connect it to the terminal, you'll be able to initiate zero-time massive data transmission with the UCA network. And just like that, you'll reconnect us not only to each other, but to our past. All the lost and fragmented junk data will be compiled and restored, like bringing a dinosaur back to life from a fossil. ...4.6 billion years of history on Earth. All the wisdom and knowledge we lost since the Death Stranding will be ours again. And that, my friend, is how we'll beat this thing. Once you establish chiral communications, generating grams won't be an issue. You'll also be able to use chiral printers. Won't be long before we're able to send all kinds of things through the wire.
Except anything original. Or that's got a soul. Nothing real. Just copies.
True. Which is why we'll still need porters like you. Before and after we're made whole, we'll need men in the middle.
No rest for the wicked, huh?
Yeah, well, idle hands and all that. We'll give you the details at the dispatch terminal. Make sure you check it upstairs. Drop's waiting up there, too.
These shoes look like they've done some serious miles. Shall I dispose of them?
Wait. Hold on. There's something I want you to look into. My blood seemed to set those things off. Happened more than once.
Set them off? How do you mean?
I don't know. You took my blood, didn't you? You tell me.
All right. I'll see what I can do.
Extend the chiral network from here to Portland City. But don't think you can make a beeline straight for it. Signal won't carry that far. To cover the distance, we need to utilize knots. Think of it like tying ropes together to make a longer rope. The first of these knots is a Bridges way station. Go ahead and take a look at the order. Deliver whatever they need and connect the Cupid. Central Knot City brought deliveries to a standstill. Until now. Your cargo for this run is a batch of smart drugs. Oxytocin, to be precise. Oxytocin is effective at reducing stress. So much so that
Some folks call it a love or happy hormone. Once you've completed the job, connect the way station to the network using the Cupid. Sam, order summaries may contain information critical to your success. Make sure to review them before getting underway. Sam, now we've supplied you with some rope and a ladder for this run. They should help with the steeper inclines, and the ladder will also make a halfway decent bridge if you need to cross a river. Right now, I figure you're thinking about how you want to handle this order. Sign someone left over there. You can leave some of your own if you'd like. Messages, warnings, words of encouragement, whatever comes to mind.
Roundabout way of saying, but that thing on your shoulder can help you locate mislaid shipments.
Remember, Sam, every parcel is a promise made to a person in need, and they're counting on you to deliver. Sam, remember that prolonged exposure to timefall damages cargo containers. Don't stay out in the rain any longer than you have to.
Thank you.
Humanity had to scramble like rats fleeing a sinking ship. But there's nowhere else to go. There's no future living like this. If we're to survive, we need to find another way. A way to overcome the BTs, the Death Stranding, the whole damn mess.
Scanning Bridges ID. Verifying ID. Clear. Cargo verified. Thank you. Delivering cargo.
Of Central Knot City. No one seemed to know what it meant for the organization, or the UCA, or us. The oxytocin will take the edge off, and that'll be a big help. Won't be long before we're back on track. We may have a luck. This is great. Yeah, and sooner. second team, right? Where are the others?
Dead. Caught in the void out.
No way. That one blast got them all? And what, they just sent you out on your own? I mean, if it was just a delivery, that'd be one thing. Porters come through from time to time, but... the second team was meant to bring the Cupid. They were gonna connect us up. 3 years we've been waiting for help. 3 years! And they sent us one guy who... Shit! Tell me you brought more than the Oxy, at least.
I've got the Cupid.
You... really? So it's true. I finally got it working. Well, then you just might be the answer to my prayers. So what are you waiting for? You put us on the goddamn grid? City, it's really happening. We can. Yeah, gonna be a lot of.
Thank you, Sam. By bringing that way station into the Cairo network.
Right.
West of the way station are a couple of structures our previous expedition put in place, and beyond them is your next destination, Port Knot City. It's on the shore of a crater lake that formed after the first void out. Your objective is to link up Port and Capital Knot. But to do that, you'll need to utilize our facilities as additional waypoints. They'll be essential for establishing a stable connection. Given the distance we need to cover, we're looking at using a distribution center and a power station, as to which you should head for first. Start with the distro center. We've got some cargo that needs delivering anyway. Check the nearby delivery terminal to pick it up.
Good work. New order available.
Your hard work's paying off, Sam. Thanks to the increase in network capacity, HQ is now in a position to provide you with additional materials and support. Should prove useful. To build a post box, you'll need to use a PCC. It goes without saying, but if you're not already carrying a PCC, you'll want to fabricate one. Sam, you can use that PCC to build a post box. Site I designated to build that post box, would you? You should have no trouble finding it if you check your map and compass from time to time.
Weapons restrictions lifted.
Beginning scan. Scan weapons restrictions lifted.
Just you, yourself, and me.
Designated site.
Select share locker. You can share cargo and equipment with your fellow porters. Deposit a ladder and a climbing anchor, and I'm sure someone will eventually come along who could use it. If you've got enough supplies, why not leave some behind? If you're right by others, they'll be right by you. Sam, you can...
Destination ASAP if you don't want to get caught. Trouble, huh? I think it was raining.
Even they know better than to mess with BTs.
Yeah.